Good morning, neighbors. Sing this song by Don Moen.
I just want to be where you are, dwelling daily in your presence. I don't want to worship from afar. Draw me near to where you are. I just want to be where you are. In your dwelling place. Take me to the place where you are. I just want to be with you. I want to be where you are. Dwelling in your presence, feasting at your table, surrounded by your glory in your presence. That's where I always want to be. I just want to be. I just want to be.
I think sometimes that when we walk with the Lord, we forget the simplicity of when we came to Him. We just really wanted to be closer to Him. We want to be in His presence. And sometimes we can forget that along the way, that we start looking at ourselves like we're not good enough, or I need to have all this and understanding. And that's good. You should desire, because just like in a marriage, you should want to get to know this loved one more. It's not, oh, I've learned everything, now we're married. It's, we get married and we just continually find more and more. And that's why when people are older, say, you know, I love them more now than I did at the beginning. But sometimes we need to go back to the beginning and just say, you know, when it first started out, it was this love. I just want to be in the presence of the Lord. You're going to wait for church to begin because I want to be in the presence of the Lord. And you couldn't wait to pray in the morning or at night or read your Bible. I've heard so many testimonies of people saying, you know, I worked on an assembly line, but I'd have my Bible at the end and just, I just have a few seconds, 10 seconds between having to put something together and I'd look at the scripture. Or, you know, my dad, he worked at a hard job, you know, for years as a physical labor, and yet he'd stay up to read the Word of God, you know, and he loved to be at church. He loved to be with people who loved him. Loved him and loved the Lord, you know, because it's love God, love your neighbor. And, you know, when I read this scripture, it's come from Psalm 27, I believe, in verse 4. One thing have I desired of the Lord, that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. For in the time of trouble he shall hide me in his pavilion, in the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me. He shall set me upon a rock, And now shall mine head be lifted up above mine enemies round about me. Therefore will I offer in his tabernacle sacrifices of joy. I will sing, yea, I will sing praises unto the Lord. Hear, O Lord, when I cry with my voice. Have mercy also upon me, and answer me. When thou saidst, Seek ye my face, my heart said unto thee, Thy face, Lord, will I seek. Hide not thy face far from me. Put not thy servant away in anger. Thou hast been my help. Leave me not, neither forsake me, O God of my salvation. You know, and David, he was a man who in the natural had, I mean, he started out as a shepherd. I mean, he's the story. I mean, they make movies about him. You know, all these things. He started out as a shepherd. Then he defeats Goliath. He becomes a king. And he has everything on earth that he could want. And yet he said, you know, but in your presence, this one thing have I desired, to be in your presence, to be in your house, to be there where you are. That's something that I think sometimes we forget. You know, just to be in your presence, Lord. That's really where I long to be, you know, and there, and like he's saying, you know, Lord, if you would turn your face from me and I would not feel your presence or be near you, what a good is this life then? Oh, well, you're rich, you're a king, and you could have all the wives you wanted, all the power and all these things, and you have really have no one to answer to. But he said, no, I have to answer to God, and in his presence, everything else pales. You know, it's just not worth nearly as what you think it is. And he even says, when my father and my mother forsake me, then the Lord will take me up. You know, and that scripture really spoke to me years ago. You know, because you think, surely not your mother and father, they'll always be on your side. And though I had good parents, the point he's trying to make is, everything can turn against you. But if you still have the Lord, it's good enough, and it's enough. So when I sing this song, I think it's a beautiful song because it's just a meditation song, a song to be in the presence of the Lord. So Lord, let us not forget. Let us go back to the beginning and seek your face just to be in your presence, just to feel that love. Oh, what about this? What about? Sometimes you just put all things aside, you know, and Lord, with all the knowledge that you've given me, you know, and all these wonderful things, sometimes I just need to go back and say, Lord, one thing I desire, that is to be in your presence. So Lord, help us in Jesus Christ's name. Amen.